Rancho Guadalupe Dunes County Park is located in the northwest corner of Santa Barbara County. The northern boundary is defined by the Santa Maria River. The river runs through the agriculturally productive valley of Santa Maria, where it comes out here to the park, flows through the park, and meets the Pacific Ocean. The park is approximately 600 acres and was established in 1987. The park is run by the County of Santa Barbara Park Service. This park is renowned for miles of pristine sand dunes along the shore and many sensitive plants and animals, including the threatened western snowy plover and the endangered California leased tern. The park provides beach access, bird watching and whale watching, outstanding photography opportunities, fishing, hiking, a picnic area, interpretive kiosks, and all sorts of recreational and educational opportunities. This park is unique in the sense that it doesn't have a system of established trails. You're free to come and wander throughout and explore all the different habitats that are offered. The park has beach strand and surf, active foredune areas, stabilized dunes, vegetated dunes, dune slacks, which are a type of special wetlands that we find in the dunes here, and a variety of other ecosystems, supporting a vast array of botanical and wildlife resources. The park is part of the larger Guadalupe-Nipomo Dunes complex. This complex is one of the largest dune complexes in the United States. This stretches from 18 miles from Pismo Beach down to Point Sal. It has some of the tallest dunes, over 550 feet tall, on the West Coast. In 1923, the epic movie, The Ten Commandments, directed by Cecil B. DeMille, was filmed here at Guadalupe Dunes County Park. At the end of the production, the massive sets reproducing ancient Egypt were dismantled and buried on the site. Other films that have been made here include G.I. Jane, Hidalgo, and recently, Pirates of the Caribbean, starring Johnny Depp. Dunes like these are formed by a combination of factors. These dunes are called aeolian dunes, which is Latin for created by wind. The combination of factors in play here require sediment being deposited on the coastline and then that material being blown inland. Here we have the Santa Maria River as our source for the sand and the sediment. It washes out into the Pacific Ocean and is washed back up onto the beach where the strong winds, and we really do have strong winds here, blow it back inland, creating these magnificent dunes. With approximately 600 acres, numerous threatened and endangered and other rare species, and lots of recreational activities, county park staff has to maintain a balance between protecting the ecological resources and providing all the opportunities for us to enjoy the dunes. Here where the beach meets the ocean, this environment is incredibly dynamic and changes constantly with every tide and, in fact, with every wave. As we move inland, the dune system becomes increasingly stable. Plants, even the most aggressive plants, are able to start to take hold. Their root structure holds the sand in place, and their above ground portion blocks a little bit of wind and allows a little bit of sand to accumulate behind it. That in turn increases the stability of that little area, and another plant can take off. These create the little dune hummocks that we see in the foredunes. As we continue to move inland, larger stands of plants, more diversity of plants tend to take over, and we get increasingly stable dunes. The original inhabitants of this area were the Chumash Indians, who lived here for 9,000 or more years. The Guadalupe Cultural Arts and Education Center in the city of Guadalupe is a terrific area to learn more about their culture and their history. Other communities have lived out here as well. Between the 1920s and the 1940s, a group of mystics, nudists, artists, writers, and hermits called the Dunites lived out in this area. They believed that the dunes were a center of creative energy and even published a magazine called the Dune Forum. Today, the diversity of use in the dunes is spectacular, from photographers to surfers to fishermen, nature watchers, all sorts of enthusiasts, and everyone from all ages. People come from around the world to visit Guadalupe Dunes County Park. Rancho Guadalupe Dunes County Park provides great access to the coast. The road is easy out here through the dunes, and it's a scenic drive past the river and the riparian corridor that it supports, through the back dunes, all the way through the fore dunes, and right out here to the beach. The parking lot provides picnic areas and restrooms and has a nice walkway right on down to the strand. The Santa Maria River runs along the northern border of the park. Each year, when the river is at its lowest, a terminal lagoon is created behind the beach strand where the water builds up. This creates a vast wetland area supporting a myriad of wildlife and botanical resources. As the rain begins through the year and as the winter proceeds, eventually it reaches the point where the river pushes across the sand dunes and reconnects with the Pacific Ocean right here at Guadalupe Dunes County Park.